Hey guys, so I'm here to give my update for day 6 and 7 of the Booktubeathon, and the Booktubeathon is over now. So I'm also going to give my update in this video. Let's get started, shall we? Yes. So on day 6, I got to page 120 of More Than This by Patrick Ness, which wasn't such great progress because I was on page 48 on day 5, but I did read some. I was really enjoying it so far. It was so gripping. I just wanted to keep on reading, but I didn't really have the time to. So the writing is seriously amazing, and I just love where the story was going. And every part really got me really scared for the main character because we don't know what's going to happen. And then on day 7, which is yesterday, I finished all of it. I finished all of More Than This because it was the last day, and I put myself in a serious reading mode, breezed through all 450 pages of it. And honestly, wow, it's so good. This book really takes some unexpected turns that I did not expect, and I really, really did love it. And it's one of those books that you kind of have to read to understand for yourself, but I really like the turn that it took. The characters in this are seriously also amazing, and the writing is amazing, and the plot is amazingly paced. I would definitely recommend it to you guys if you guys like a bit of mystery and horror and action, because it definitely has all of those. And because I put myself in intense reading mode, I also got through 59 pages of Things Fall Apart. I like it so far. It definitely hasn't lost my interest yet, so I look forward to keep on reading it. So yeah, got through 59 pages of Things Fall Apart. So let's move on to the wrap up. So the first book I picked up through the Booktubeathon was Angel Fall by Suzanne E, and this is the book that completes the challenge of reading a book that BookTube made me read, and I think it was really good. I really enjoyed it. Looking back on it, if I compare it to some of the other books that I read, it definitely wasn't the best book that I read, but I still enjoyed it nevertheless. It's very action-packed and exciting, and it has a lot of horror in it as well. And then I went on to reading Me Before You by Jojo Moyes. Now this is a book that I really, really enjoyed. I think it was beautifully written. It's a romance book. There's more themes than romance in this book. There's also the theme of living and making your life as full as possible, and I really like that aspect about this book. It was very well written, but it was a bit long, but I love the main characters and I love how this book went. And this book completes the challenge of reading a book and then watching the book to movie adaptation, which I did watch the movie adaptation and I liked it. It wasn't nearly as good as I was hoping it was, but I think it was still a very worthwhile movie to watch. And then I breezed through Nimona by Noelle Stevenson. This book is a graphic novel, and this was one of those books that was a really quick read. It has great characters and great humor and lots of aspects of fantasy and fighting and dragons. And the ending was very unexpected for me, but I do love it and I do love the illustrations. So that is the third book that I read. I was intending to complete the challenge of reading this book after sunset, but I didn't really do it for that. And then I read More Than This by Patrick Ness. I think this might be my favorite book out of the Booktubeathon that I read. It was such an unexpected read. Everything in this book was very unexpected for me. I did not expect it at all. It was like this entire book was a plot twist. And I really do love how this book went in a direction that I did not expect. Every time I thought I knew what was going on. And this book completes the challenge of reading a book with yellow on the cover. And then lastly, I got through 59 pages of Things Fall Apart, and this is the last book that I was reading before the Booktubeathon ended. It's not really a book that I would regularly pick up. The plot is just not something that would have intrigued me, but I do really like it. And this book was meant to complete the challenge of reading a book that is older than me. These 5 books are all the books that I read slash sort of read through the Booktubeathon. Really proud of my progress this year. I think it went really well. I started out really strong, but then I definitely slacked off a little when I was reading More Than This. And I did waste my time a little and procrastinate, but 4.5 books is still a really great number, and I'm really proud of myself for it. I think my favorite 2 books out of the Booktubeathon would have to be More Than This, and it's a tie between Me Before You and Nimona. So there you go. And then, because I didn't do an update video for day 6, we're gonna do the video challenges for both day 6 and day 7 of the Booktubeathon. And day 6 is to create a road trip with the settings of books. So for me, I would firstly start off with going to Britain, which is a setting in Me Before You, and then also going to Paris, which is a place that the main character did go to in the book. And then I would like to make my way to Manhattan, which is the setting of most of the Percy Jackson books. and go explore. I would also like to go to all the places that Violet and Finch went to in All the Bright Places by Jennifer Niven. And then lastly, I would go to Alaska. I think this is where they went. Following this, I would go to outer space. And finally, end with going to the moon in winter. So that is my road trip done. It's a hell of a road trip, I'll tell you guys that. And then on to the video challenge for day 7, which is to retell the story of a book using book covers. And for that, my book of choice is All the Bright Places by Jennifer Niven. I have read this book very recently, so the details are still fresh on my mind, so I thought I would tell you guys the summary of this in book covers. So in All the Bright Places, what happens is that there is a boy and a girl, there you go, named Violet and Finch, and the girl is one day found on a bell tower trying to commit suicide. She's standing at the edge and she's ready to jump off, but then the boy jumps in and he saves her, and the girl wanted to jump off the tower because she's having a pretty bad life. Sister was killed in a car crash. There's my car over there. So that's why she wanted to kill herself. But then Finch came in, and as a school project, they have to visit places in their city, and they bond over this, and somehow miraculously they sort of change each other's lives and show each other what it means to be living. So that was the summary for All the Bright Places. I hope I did not make you guys not want to read this book now. So after all of those hectic catch-ups and updates and wrap-ups, we are finally done with the booktube-a-thon, and I just want to say it was a great week for me to get a lot of reading done, and I really enjoyed it. I'm definitely going to be doing the booktube-a-thon next year. Do let me know how your booktube-a-thon went, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!